You know, recently they are beginning to burnt down INEC offices, especially in the south, I mean in the east. My question is this: why do you think they are targeting INEC offices these days?
You see, at times, that is why our Igbo brothers, the way they feel, they always overreacted. It's not good. INEC don't have anything to do with what is going on, because it is the resources of the state that they will use to go and rebuild those things, and they have many things to do. So as for me, I don't support maybe destroying anything, that because it is for we, I can say we masses, the populace, that this thing is very important for. Share, you understand? And you are just, it's not too far. Maybe in the local government election, maybe anything, whatever. That is the power that you have. You know, it has been happening since 2015. When people, this fat social party, we say, I vote for, okay, for you, they give you money, just go there. And you do your own mind. If you believe, okay, Mr. A is the, okay, he's not doing good, B is not good, then you go for the C, then you put your this thing. Your people told so as a proverb that, Omitoba money on Lore Lassi, when you have large number of votes, so nobody can rig it. Check, you understand? So that is what. So I will employ our brothers in the northeast or south, in the southeast, to be patient, not to destroy the government property or whatever. So it's very important. We are appealing to them. So you don't do things in a hard way. Uh-huh. When the time that you do that, but not now. Uh-huh. It's not yet time to do it the hard way. So that is it. Uh-huh. So when this year go, the negotiation, whatever is going on, maybe by next year, and if the government in power remain undermanned, is it not last week or so that I read in the newspaper, I don't know the state, said that they should go back to the confab of 1914. All they don't know, all they organize, whatever, control that everybody, because things have, we believe that maybe since 2004 things have changed, so that let each state bring out its own people. Uh-huh. Not only from the political part that we say that, oh no, it is Westminster, because they will say that it was maybe it's also Freddy that sent them, so they will come and protect the things. Let the CDC, CDA, including the others from each community, to bring out his people. This is what we want. Then everybody negotiate. And I believe that after 2014, then most people, you can see that there's no much argument. The document is, if they can go and implement that alone, I'm sure that Nigeria will take back our glory as the giant of Africa. But as now, we are a toothless bulldog.
You see, tiro ba lo logun odun jo ti ododo ba gbera lo ma overtake. The burning of INEC office and all of them, as much as I do not actually like it, but I cannot condemn it.
Why?
Because 2023 is not logical. If we want to be together by 2023, there is need for us to sit down and discuss the existence of this country. Monkey cannot be working assiduously while baboon is somewhere chopping.
Okay.
Are you with me? I pray what I'm saying, so you put on YouTube. I will be very glad.
Definitely.
Because YouTube is a wider distance than by terrestrial television.
Definitely.
Monkeys cannot be walking and baboons chopping. Making a statement, they want out. They want out of this contraption called Nigeria, and I duly support them. Obita to ba gbe mi o fi mi labi mo se wa. Obita le ti ati fa pa mi tan. You get the point now? So, I can never condemn them, because the system is bad. The system is bad, and the lies of this country is what they are fighting against. Fulani terrorists are there. You refuse to brand them their name. Freedom fighters who are agitating for a right to own their land, you branded them terrorists. How many Igbo men have gone from the east to the north to go and keep people there? As of this morning, a community in Enugu State is crying that Fulani herdsmen are planning to attack them. That is intelligence report. In the next 2 days now, you will hear. The government has had it today. Will they get up? I am pretty sure they will not. So why do you think they won't be burning INEC offices? They won't be burning down attacking police stations.
But do you think that is the solution we needed now? Even if at all they are not going to be election on, 2023. But do you think burning down INEC offices, burning down police stations, do you think is the solution to solve this problem where we are into? And then who are those people? From your own opinion, who do you think are those people that are doing this issue, that are doing these things?
Number one, let me tell you the truth. Nigeria is now a cancer. And you cannot cure cancer without spilling blood. You understand? You cannot cure cancer without spilling blood. Yeah.